this will be part two on the military theme. A little bit different here. We're going to run a couple of trains by TTHF, which was the Toy Train Historical Foundation. And they only made a few products. This particular set is basically a reproduction of a 1917-1921 Lionel set. Set would have come with the plane and cannon as you see it here, but also would have had soldiers and tents and some armored cars and things like that. I don't have the box set with all the accessories, I just have the train, and I'm more than happy to have that because there were so few made. This outfit was a follow-on to the Army set that we just saw. This one was called the General Salute, and it's called the General Salute because most of the cars are named after generals. That one is a Bradley, Patton, a Pershing, Eisenhower, and all the way down here at the end is a MacArthur. Now, just for the heck of it, I have collected Mark's figurines of each of the appropriate generals, and just for this little bit, they're sitting on top of their car. What makes this particular set unusual, and it's the only one like it, you'll notice the first batch of cars here, here's an Eisenhower, and it's got the tan body and the blue roof. And when you come down here, this Eisenhower, the colors are reversed. And same with the Pershing and the Patton and so on. The MacArthur was not done in reverse colors, nor was the club car. The way you see this set with the reverse colors, this is the only set like it that exists. What it was the cars were done for one time only in the two different colors so they could look at them and decide what color combination they wanted. Well, the production version was the tan body with the blue roof. And even then, only 25 or so sets were ever made. But I have the only ones with the reverse colors. These were the color samples from one of the founders of the company. This is the style box that they would have come in. Both the General Salute and the Army set came in this box. There was also a Navy set that looked pretty much like the Army set, and a Bosnia set that again had the same makeup as the Army set. The Navy set was done in a kind of a battleship gray. The Bosnia set was done in a kind of an ugly blue, if you ask me. Those are about the only products that they made in this line. So if you see one of these boxes buried under a table at a show someplace, you might want to look inside. There might be a treasure inside.
Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the Army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. A-toot-a-toot-a-toot-a-toot-a-toot-a-rosy-day to the bar. In boogie rhythm, he can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with him.
He makes a company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
He was a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie woogie bugle, he was busy as a bluebeam. And when he plays, he makes a company jump A to the bar. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He blows it A to the bar. He can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with him. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Boogie every night and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands.